It's about a young girl who I play called Angel, and one day she's kidnapped by some soldiers and taken to work in a brothel where young girls are being prostituted to the military. But she's not prostituted, she's used as kind of a slave to look after the girls, and she gets a friendship with one of the girls and they become really, really close. And then that girl dies, and then that kind of causes her to seek revenge, and she doesn't want to kind of be in this situation anymore, so she breaks out and it turns into a bit of a cat and mouse game, really. I think it's really important. I mean, so often things that are going on in the world try to be swept under the carpet, and there are people that have said that this is kind of exploiting the situation, but I always say, if you want to pretend that this situation didn't happen, then that's your prerogative. But actually, we're trying to show you that this happened and does still happen in some countries around the world and is a current issue today, and we want to get that out there. And I think films that kind of make people think and deliver a message are always films that I'm most interested in, certainly. We did a lot of research, or as much research as we thought we needed for kind of the character, and it is based on a true story of a young girl that did do what Angel does in the film, but being deaf was rather challenging, because obviously you can't block off your hearing at all, so you just kind of have to go along with it. And I have worked with deaf children before, so I know how they react to things, and so I kind of took that into account. But it was definitely an experience, because you can't block off your hearing and you just kind of have to be really focused. And but I love learning all the sign language for the film. That was really, really great.
It's a remarkably physical performance. You're a bit like John McClane at times, crawling through the vents and pipes. Can you talk a little bit about that aspect of the filming?
I do all my own stunts, apart from one, which was smashing my head through glass, which they wouldn't let me do, which was fair enough. So I trained with a really great stunt team who made sure we did it all safely. And so I fall out of windows, I kind of fight big, burly men. I kill quite a few people in very different ways. So it was really cool. But I haven't used any methods since finishing filming.
There are some scenes in particular that are very difficult to watch. Were there any in particular that you found challenging to shoot or left a lasting impression on you?
Yeah, there are a few. The worst one really was the scene where Vanya dies. She's raped to death. Really horrible way to die. And shooting that was really difficult, because me and Dominic were really good friends and it seemed very real when we were doing it. And then that kind of shows what amazing actors Dominic and Ryan are. But it seemed really real, and that was really hard. And the crew all felt very uncomfortable that day. But generally, apart from that day, we always tried to kind of have fun and kind of have some lightheartedness to it, because shooting a very grim film, we didn't want everyone to be depressed, so we just kind of had to keep going and like kind of raise morale. And it was, and it sounds weird to say, but it was a really happy, fun shoot, so that was really good.
You need to have a lot of trust, I'd imagine, in your director when you're filming this kind of material. Can you talk a little bit about working with Paul and how he supported you in the performance?
Working with Paul was amazing. It was a very collaborative process. We kind of sat down and thought about who Angel was and what she's been through and where she's going, which was really, really good. But it's amazing watching him work, obviously, given his background in makeup and prosthetics and kind of him now directing. I would have never known he was a first-time director ever. And he was really, really great. But I loved it when he'd get his makeup palette out and like tweak some kind of makeup on set. I thought that was really cool, kind of his two worlds. But no, I think he's done a great job, yeah. Working with Sean was really cool. He really goes for it. Every single take, he puts everything he has into it. And so that brought a lot out in me. And we were lucky. We had a really great cast, which was good considering the movie was quite intense. And everyone got on really well. And I think that always helps shooting a scene. If everybody likes each other, then filming's so much easier. And so I was really lucky. And everyone looked after me, which was nice, because I think they were aware of my age and they wanted to make sure kind of I was always okay, which I was. And working with Sean, I mean, my brother's a massive Sean Pertwee fan, yeah. So he got a photo with him, so that was really nice. So yeah, no, it was really cool.
Can you talk a little bit about working with Anna and what you think starting the film with that amount of love brought to the film?
Yeah, working with Anna was really great. She's really good fun to work with, and she always gives a lot in scenes, so that's really awesome to work kind of against her. But I think that's an important scene, because you get to see where Angel came from and all the love that she had, and it almost makes the situation that she's in a lot worse, because she's had a good life, and she's minus the fact that she's deaf, she's just a normal young girl with a loving family. And then obviously when the soldiers invade, it all goes wrong. And so I think the love and the kind of happiness that she has the start of the movie really kind of makes what happens in the end even worse. Well, a lot of women have really enjoyed the film. We get a lot of feedback from women saying how much they enjoyed it, and it's kind of a very strong feminist character that really goes for it, and she won't give up. And so I think kind of in terms of that's probably a positive message, but I'm not really sure there's a lot of positivity in the film, as it is rather bleak, but hopefully we get mixed reviews, but yeah. Obviously it's a very kind of dark film, and we always knew it'd be a bit like Marmite, you'd either love it or you'd hate it, but there are lots of people that really get the film, that understand what we're doing with the message, that it is all based on a true story. So people that really understand the film really, really love it, and that's really great. Obviously you get some people that it's just not their cup of tea because it is very dark, but I've been delighted with some of the responses, so yeah, really, really good.
What are we going to see you in coming up? I believe you've got some more features. I think 16 is that one?
I've got a movie called 16, which is kind of in a similar vein to Fish Tank. It's very kind of urban and dark, about a former child soldier that now lives in London and his life, and I'm his slightly chubby but quite nice girlfriend. I'm in Warner Brothers' new film, Ironclad Battle for Blood, playing a medieval princess. And I'm also in the new series of Misfits that airs in August, I think. Yeah.
Tell us more about Misfits.
I can't, unfortunately. Well, I mean, that's why I'm in it, but that's all I'm allowed to say. Yeah.